هل لكم أسئلة أخرى؟ بقية الأسئلة.
The second question.
لكن سؤالين لا أدري بأي أبدأ. لكن إذا كنا في الموضوع الفلسطيني والإسرائيلي نتطرق إلى خطبة على مولانا أمير المؤمنين حضرة خليفة المسيح الثالث رحمه الله في قرأت هذه في مجلة بشرة قديمة في سنة 73 وهناك هذه الخطبة كانت انذار للعالم وجاء فيها أنا أعرف النص العربي لا أعرف إذا كان هذا في الأردو يقول حضرته لقد فكرت وأطلت التفكير وقد أوحى إلي الله سبحانه وتعالى أنه ما بين 20 إلى 30 سنة القادمة ستواجه الجماعة ظروفا صعبة وحاسمة للغاية وكذلك العالم بأسره فنرى أن الشطر الأول تحقق في الجماعة في باكستان والظلم والاضطهاد وغيرها الآن أسأل حضرته ماذا مع الشطر الثاني لهذه النبوءة لأن هناك يقول
First of all, it should be remembered that the translation is definitely wrong. But I'll come to it after the translation.
Our honorable brother, he said that I read in one of our magazine, Al-Bushra, published in 1973, in which Hadrat Khalifat al-Masih III, he has said that after I thought very, very deeply, Allah has revealed to me that for the next coming 20 or 30 years, our Jamaat will go through very difficult times, and so will go the whole world.
He said he sent wahi on me
yes.
after my contemplation of this.
Yes. And he has commented, Brother Sharif, that we have seen the persecution through which our Jamaat went through for the last few years. And he would like to know what will happen for...
No, use the word Oha Ilahi. That is what he claimed according to the translation.
Revealed, this word. Yeah.
Revealed is not enough. Revealed is maybe through intuition, through other things, that God had spoken to him and told him categorically that this is what is going to happen. This is what you
yes. Say. Okay, I will repeat. That he said that Hadrat Khalifat al-Masih III, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that after he has thought very deeply, God has spoken to him very clearly, and he said that for the next coming 20 or 30 years, our Jamaat will go through difficult times, and the world as a whole as well will go through similar type of difficult times. Now, our brother Sharif would like to know, he said
that... That's all or something else which follows?
هل هناك بقية لهذا؟
بعد ذلك يتطرق أن وقد أوحى الله سبحانه وتعالى من قبل لسيدنا المسيح الموعود عن حرب عن كارثة عظمى ستحدث في العالم
That is what is related to this is why I said
Also,
add to this what he is saying.
Also, he has linked that what Hazrat Masih Maud and Imam Mahdi alayhi salatu wasalam has published that God has spoken to him clearly that
Shukhar the Third World War
حول
حرب العالمية الثالثة التي تكون أشد وأصعب من الحربين السابقتين
concerning the Third World War which will be
حرب العالمية الأولى والثانية
it will be more أشد more yes that's right more destructive than the first and second world war more destructive
well that's all right but what is attributed to him is not just this he said that it was revealed to him by God through revelation ilham or wahi that by the end of this century that destructive war which will destroy most of the dominant nations would take place. This is what is attributed to him, which he did not say. What he said was that judging from signs which he read, judging from the ilhamat or wahi on Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, etc., he believes that before the next century begins, the global war which will completely change the complexion of the earth in favor of Islam would take place. And the Western nations will be completely obliterated. But this is a wrong interpretation, wrong translation attributed to him. What he said was, he viewed things to happen like this. He understands that this would happen. I once attended a press conference where one of the prominent journalists who attended this conference where he said this in London, he objected against this statement by saying that this means that the whole world will be destroyed and within that period. I said, no, this is not what he said. What he said was he thinks, he thought, he interpreted the prophecies of Masih Maud Islam and the prophecies of before him, that the Third World War, which would be so destructive, would take place by the end of this century. Within 30 years he had prophesied. And that was done in around 70 or something. 67. So 30 years since 67 have already passed. It's 97. Isn't right?
Yes.
Already passed. And that has not happened. But I made it clear many years ago, many years before this point in time when the 30 years expired, that he never said it. It has been attributed to him by the press. What he said was he thought, he understood from this that this would take place. And then I have myself spoken on this subject on my own behalf and said that what the prophecies, what I understand of the prophecies, the century is not the limit for their fulfillment. And they cannot be. It's impossible. Because according to what I understand from the Quran of the nature of the holy war against other religions, as long as you are winning converts in sufficient numbers, the people cannot be destroyed. It is impossible. If the Europeans or the Western people belonging to Christianity or other faiths, they respond positively to the call of Islam, as they have started doing so now with the efforts of the Da'iyina Ilallah of Jamaat Ahmadiyya, how can God change his sunnah beginning from the time of Hazrat Adam, not to bring his wrath upon a people who are responding and who are converting? Such terrible punishments as are mentioned can only befall such people about whom God has passed the judgment that from now on they are not going to accept. And whatever they will give birth to would be Fasik and Fajr, Fajran or Fujarar, as is mentioned in the Holy Quran. That is the moment in time when God decides to wipe them out, not before that. That is why the Arabs, despite the fact that they left no stone unturned to destroy Islam and Muhammad Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, were given this long lease of time. They demanded punishment. They categorically challenged Hazrat Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now, make the stones from heaven fall upon us, we demand it. And he said, I can't do it, Allah has to decide. And Allah knew that the entire Mecca was to become Muslim. The entire Arabia was to become Muslim in the lifetime of Hazrat Muhammad. So that did not happen. No stones were showered on them. So this is what we should look forward to. We should understand the grand plan of things which has been unfolded throughout the religious history. And we must quicken our pace of preaching. That is the only formula to save the world from the ultimate holocaust which awaits them if they do not respond positively to the call of Islam. Understand? Have you understood the message? The rest he will tell you.
يقول حضرة أمير المؤمنين أن ما قاله حضرة الخليفة الثالث رضي الله تعالى عنه كان استنتاج من المعطيات التاريخية المعروفة في ذلك الوقت وأيضا من الإلهامات سيدنا مرزا غلام أحمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. فسيدنا أحمد عليه الصلاة والسلام قد أخبره الله سبحانه وتعالى أنه ستقوم حرب عظيمة وأن هذه القوى الغربية ستتحطم، وهذه النبوة لابد كما تعرفون أن يكون لها تأويل. فيقول حضرة أمير المؤمنين أن حضرته شخصيا قد حضر ندوة صحفية وقد سئل في هذه الندوة وقد سئل حضرته عن ما قاله حضرة الخليفة الثالث رضي الله تعالى عنه، واستنكر حضرة أمير المؤمنين الحالي ما قاله أوله هؤلاء الصحفيون، وقال لهم أن هذا في الحقيقة كان تأويلا لنبوءات سيدنا مرزا غلام أحمد عليه الصلاة والسلام، أي ما قاله الخليفة الثالث كان في الحقيقة تأويلا لنبوءات سيدنا أحمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. ويقول حضرة أمير المؤمنين ما قاله حضرة الخليفة الثالث كان في حوالي سنة 1900.
And I said, if no time limit was mentioned by Hazrat Masih Maud Islam at all.
وأضاف حضرت وقال أن حضرت مرزا غلام أحمد عليه الصلاة والسلام لم يحدد وقتا لتحقيق هذه النبوات. ثم يقول حضرت من المؤمنين أن هذا الإدلاء الصحفي قد قام به حضرت الخليفة الثالث في سنة 1967، ونحن الآن كما تعرفون قد مضى الآن 30 سنة وأصبحنا في سنة 1997. يقول حضرت من المؤمنين أنني استنكرت هذا ما نسبوه لحضرة الخليفة الثالث رضي الله تعالى عنه في سنين طويلة وقبل سنين طويلة من وصولنا إلى سنة 97. ويقول حضرته أن ما أفهمه شخصيا من النبوآت القرآنية وهو أنه ما دام الكثير من الناس يدخلون في الإسلام هكذا الله سبحانه وتعالى لن يحطمهم، إذ كيف الله سبحانه وتعالى يغير سنته، أي كيف الله سبحانه وتعالى يعذب هؤلاء الناس وهم يدخلون إلى الإسلام ويتبعون الطريق الصحيح. ولكن أولئك الذين قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في حقهم أنهم لن يرجعوا إلى الطريق الصحيح وليس هنالك أي أمل من إصلاحهم، ثم يقرر الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يمحوهم من على وجه الأرض، فهؤلاء قد نزل فيهم ذلك القرار الإلهي الذي لا رجعة فيه. ويقول حضرة أمير المؤمنين ويذكرنا بحادثة العرب الذين قبلوا الإسلام في وقت الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وكيف أن الله سبحانه وتعالى لم يعاقبهم، إذ بقبولهم من الإسلام هذا يمحو كل وعود قد نزلت في حقهم في الماضي.
جزاكم this unchangeable fundamental principle is laid down by the Holy Quran in response to those who said na amtir alayna hijarata min as-sama we will have shaitan rajim wa ma kana allahu li yu'adhibahum wa anta fi number 1 وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ See? So these are the eternal preconditions. If they are fulfilled, if the people begin to turn to God and seek forgiveness of Allah, by representation, all of them do not become always immediately Muslims or repentant. But once they begin to turn to God, God would not punish them. So that is why I do not agree with this understanding that by the end of the century, the Third World War would certainly take place. It may or may not. It's not a determining factor. The determining factors would be the attitude of the world as a whole. When God sees that they have finally rejected all efforts of turning them to Islam, that would be the moment when that global Holocaust would take place.
قد وجد حضرة أمير المؤمنين الآية التي كان يتحدث عنها وهي بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما كان الله ليعذبهم وأنت فيهم وما كان الله معذبهم وهم يستغفرون. يقول حضرة أمير المؤمنين هذه هي القواعد الإلهية التي وضعها الله سبحانه وتعالى منذ الأزل ولن يغيره ولا عفوا ولن يغيرها الله سبحانه وتعالى. فيقول حضرته بناء على هذه القواعد المتينة قد استنتجت هذا استنتاجي، ولذلك لا أوافق القول أن مع نهاية هذا القرن ستقوم تلك الحرب العالمية الثالثة. أي هذه الآية تخبرنا صراحة أن إذا الناس يستغفرون أن يرجعوا لله سبحانه وتعالى لن يتحقق فيهم هذا الوعد، ولكن إذا رفضوا ولن يقبل الإسلام فيمكن أن يتحقق فيهم.
Now I turn to the Palestinian embassies. Okay. When the non-Ahmadi Muslims asked you to join them in the so-called holy war of fighting the Jewish people with material weapons, you say no, because we do not agree with your interpretation of the holy war in that. And when I tell you to start the real holy war, which is fought with the Quran, and try to convert the Jewish people to Islam, you say the situation is not favorable. So what is your position? La ilaha illallah, wa la ilaha illallah. How can you be happy with this?
يقول حضرة المؤمنين الآن أنتقل إلى الفلسطينيين الأحمديين. يقول حضرته أنكم رفضتم الانضمام إلى تلك الكتلة الإسلامية التي لما نادتكم كي تنضموا إلى صفوفهم وتحاربوا اليهود بتلك الأسلحة المادية، فأنتم رفضتم وقلت لهم أن تأويلكم للحرب المقدسة له معاني أخرى في ضوء القرآن الكريم. ويقول حضرته ولكن لما دعوتكم أنا شخصيا أن تعلنوا تلك الحرب المقدسة ضد اليهود وترفعوا القرآن الكريم وتنادوهم وتبشرونهم أي أن يدخلوا في الإسلام، فأنتم رفضتم أيضا هذا النداء. فيقول حضرة المؤمنين ماذا يحصل؟ أنتم لا تنتمون لا إلى هؤلاء ولا إلى هؤلاء.
Allah save you from that.
يقول حضرته ندعو أن الله سبحانه وتعالى كي ينقذكم من هذه الأزمة.
Now I understand with the grace of Allah there is an awakening, general awakening in the Ahmadiyya Muslim communities in Kababir and around, and they have started inviting Jewish people groups to the Ahmadiyya Center and started, if not openly, at least through implications, preaching to them. But I want this to be done in a very dedicated spiritual manner, with deep, so that they are deeply convinced of the truth of Islam. All misunderstandings are removed and they say, yes, this is the faith for us. Once it begins to happen, then inshallah, a new phase of history will begin in the land Al-Ardh Al-Muqaddasa. And that would be the great movement to rejoice by the Ahmadis, inshallah.
يضيف حضرة أمير المؤمنين ويقول الآن هنالك يقظة روحية أيضا بالنسبة للأحمديين المسلمين في فلسطين. ويقول حضرته أنني قد وصلتني تقارير أن هنالك حملات تبشيرية إسلامية مع اليهود هنالك، وهنالك تنظيمات أو اجتماعات دعية فيها الكثير من اليهود هنالك، وهذا النشاط قد تحسن بكثير، وإن شاء الله سندخل في فترة جديدة أي فترة يقظة روحانية إن شاء الله.